Keysight's InfiniiVision X-Series oscilloscopes offer a broad range of power-related measurements with the power measurements option. This video is part of a series of several short videos on specific power supply-related measurements. Here we show a simplified schematic of a switch mode power supply, along with a list of measurements that can be performed on the power supply to test and characterize it. In this video demonstration, we will focus on performing a power quality measurement on the AC input, which is highlighted in green here. For our demonstration, we'll be using Keysight's switch mode power supply demo board. This is the same DUT we use in many of our hands-on workshops around the world. The first task in making a power quality measurement is to probe the AC input with voltage and current probes. You'll typically need a high voltage differential probe and a clamp-on Hall effect current probe. This particular power supply demo board has PCB current loop traces built in to make current probing easy. When making current measurements on your DUT, however, you will typically need to create your own wire current loops. Let's start making measurements. I'll begin with a default setup so we can start everything from scratch. Next, I'll go into the Analyze menu, which this menu is actually you can get to directly with the front panel key. Select the power application. Now that we have the power menu up, this pop-up shows the various power measurements that can be performed with the power option, and we have videos on each of these. We're going to select the power quality measurement. The next step is to go into the Signals menu. Now in this menu you can see a diagram similar to the diagram we showed earlier. It gives you hints on how to connect your probes. You can also assign which channel of the scope is voltage. In this case, we'll use the default channel 1. Current is channel 2. We're going to make our measurement based upon 2 cycles, and then we'll simply press Auto Setup. Now what Auto Setup does, it provides optimum scaling for the voltage waveform, which is the yellow sinusoidal looking waveform. It's a little distorted from our step down transformer. The green waveform that's pulsed is the current waveform, which is pretty typical for a power supply. And then the purple waveform is the power waveform. This is created using the scope's waveform math. It simply multiplies the instantaneous voltage times the instantaneous current to produce the power waveform. At this point, we're all ready to perform our power quality measurements. To perform the various power quality measurements, I simply press Apply. And then it automatically turns on all the important measurements, including power factor, real power, apparent power, reactive power, crest factor of voltage, in which case you can see it's about 1.38, an ideal sine wave would be 1.414, crest factor of current, phase angle, RMS voltage, and the frequency, which you can see this is 60 Hz. It also supplies full statistics, so you can get mean, min, max, standard deviation. Now you probably noticed that the statistics window with our, I think we have 8 or 9 different measurements up there, is covering up part of the waveforms. We can move this around, or you can go to transparent dialogues, or you can just simply turn the statistics off and look at the real-time updated measurements of power quality. As mentioned at the beginning of this demonstration, this short video was part of a series of several short videos on specific power supply related measurements. To learn more about InfiniiVision X-Series oscilloscopes and how they can help you test and debug your power supplies, contact your local Keysight authorized distributor and ask for a demonstration. Thank you.